The American people deserve to know that President Trump and his advisors didn't just ask me to pause. They asked me to reject votes, return votes, essentially to overturn the election.
So that is Mike Pence saying something that's true. That is very much what they were trying to do. And he has been slightly critical in the last few years of Donald Trump. But isn't it convenient that he's like super explicit about what they did after the indictment is out? Like, he could have been making this case for 2 years. He chose not to do that for reasons that aren't difficult to figure out. But he's being critical of Trump now. Okay, well, let's test that. How critical is he willing to be? Watch this.
Put yourself on that jury for just a moment. If you were on the jury, would you say that this defendant, the former president, had committed a crime that day? Do you believe it rises to the level of a crime?
Well, you know, Martha, I don't know. I mean, honestly, I don't know the full case in chief that the government has. Some of the argument that I hear coming between the lines from his lawyers is something of a concession that that he may have gotten bad advice, that he was just taking advice from his attorneys.
Okay, so look, obviously a lot of that is weaselly. I will say, yeah, it's fair to say you don't know. It's complex, it's unprecedented. Sure, you don't necessarily know. That's fine to say. But then Sabrina, he turns to, I don't know, like I'm hearing he got some bad advice, which we have already heard earlier this week is a strategy that they're considering on Trump's team, just blaming his lawyers for it, letting the co-conspirators go down. And now Mike Pence, a guy who a moment earlier was critical of him, who is running against him for the Republican nomination, is helping play into that strategy. What do you think?
I mean, I do hope that these men, not just Pence, but everybody else involved, I hope that, you know, these selfish cowards do end up turning on Trump, because this has just been a long time coming. And yeah, Mike Pence should have spoken a lot sooner. But not only that, but I feel like this process has just been taking too long in general. Like, we're talking about January 6th. How many years ago was it now? It's been taking way too long, and it's a little frightening that, you know, the election is right around the corner and people do still see Trump as a viable option. So I really, really hope that everybody continues to flip on him.
Yeah, yeah, I hope so. And we're actually gonna talk about that in just one moment, but I'm gonna allow Donald Trump to respond to Mike Pence. He says, I feel badly for Mike Pence, who is attracting no crowds, enthusiasm, or indictments, I'm kidding, out of that, or loyalty from people who, as a member of the Trump administration, should be loving him. He didn't fight against election fraud, which we will now be easily able to prove based on the most recent fake indictment, and information which will have to be made available to us finally. By the way, let's pause for a second. There is this, like, again, it's all Q from floor to ceiling. It's all Q. So their idea right now, the way that they're coping against this devastating indictment is, wait, and by they, I mean rando blue check marks on Twitter all the way up to Fox News personalities, is, wait a second. Now we're gonna have a trial, which means Jesse Waters literally said this. Every one of these states is gonna have to prove that they ran clean elections. No, you dumb donkey, what are you talking about? That's not how it's gonna go. First of all, if you are asserting that they committed voter fraud, it is on you to establish that. And you guys have tried and tried and tried and tried literally dozens of cases over the courses of years. And you've been laughed out of courtrooms all over the country. It didn't work out for you, buddy. It's not gonna happen now. And that's not what the focus of the case is gonna be. But anyway, he goes on to say, the VP had power that Mike didn't understand, but after the election, the rhinos and Dems changed the law, taking that power away. He didn't have that power, and they didn't take that power away. They tried in vain to make it as explicit as possible that just because you control the vice presidency doesn't mean you get to automatically win re-election. But the point of reading that, Sabrina, is a big portion of the indictment is about his pressure campaign against Mike Pence. And he is still bleeding that Mike Pence could have overturned the results of the election, even though he has been told by everyone that they could not have. He's still saying it. I feel like that bleat could be evidence in the trial.
That would be exciting if that was evidence. I think there was even a quote that Mike Pence had mentioned before that Donald Trump had told him that he was too truthful at one point when they were discussing this in advance. Like, that really is just, it's not helping your case. So I don't know what's gonna happen next, but I hope Mike Pence continues to share his truth.
Yeah, 100%. And then I hope that he goes away. Yeah. That would be nice.
Check out the Damage Report podcast each day, wherever you get your podcasts, whether Pocket Casts or Stitcher or iTunes. You can join me as I give you the news and stories you want, with a range of co-hosts and interview guests jumping in on the fun each day. Again, that's the Damage Report, wherever you get your podcasts. And if you get them at iTunes, don't forget to rate and review. Sometimes I'll read them live on the show.